you could say that Mark Mitchell is a what, an Australian TV legend?
Oh, yeah.
He's been around for years and years and years.
Biggest thing in the world.
Yeah, yeah. Now in a Studio 10 exclusive, Mark Mitchell opens up about an eerie gift he's had since he was a child. Take a look.
In the late 80s, he was a comedy legend, the man behind some of the Aussie TV figures we've loved the most. Famous for bringing to life our favourite fruiterer, Mark Mitchell cemented himself in TV's Hall of Fame on The Comedy Company.
Con the Fruiterer is a TV icon. How did he come about?
So we went to the market and the market was dominated by Greek stallholders and a Macedonian butcher. So I walked up to the fruiterer. He had a rocker hairdo, he had a Zapata moustache, he was down at heel, he was sucking the innards out of a tomato. And he opened his eyes and he said, "Hello, gentlemen, how are you today?" I said, "Have you got any peaches?" He said, "Yeah, yeah, yeah, in today." And he pointed at the peaches and I said, "They're like cricket balls." And I said, "They're a bit hard." He said, "Ah, come on, beautiful."
Beautiful. Those sayings became part of the Aussie vernacular. And he brought to life an array of characters, each one as endearing as the next. From Mr. Gibble in Around the Twist to starring in the Inspector Gadget franchise.
This is your last warning, Gadget. Stick to solving real crime.
There is no doubt this fab father of five has the gift of performance, but he has another talent that he's kept quiet about until now. Mark, you see dead people. Is that right?
It sounds weird when you say that, doesn't it? Yes, I have. I have. I've seen a few incidental dead people that I haven't known. But for the most part, I only see dead people that I have known.
While his connection with the dead began very early in life, it wasn't until he was 15 that he really noticed how strong that gift was. After his Aunt Mary died suddenly in a car accident and left Mark her house.
One room was locked and we couldn't find the key anywhere. After lunch, I walked into the kitchen. Mum was doing the dishes and all of a sudden, Auntie Mary appeared in sort of ghostly form, but looking really well. And I looked at her and smiled, and she smiled at me, and then she turned to my mother and started speaking. My mother couldn't see her because she stopped doing the dishes and she turned, but clearly she wasn't looking at Auntie Mary, she was looking around, as one does, but she could hear what she was saying. Then Auntie Mary smiled at me again and vanished. Mum turned and said, "Did you hear that?" And I said, "No, I saw Auntie Mary and I saw her talking to you, but I don't know what she said." Auntie Mary was from Scotland. And Mum said, she said, "Look on the wee tree." The wee tree was the name of the lemon tree in the middle of the lawn. So we went outside and despite the dull, overcast day, Disney fashion, a single ray of sunlight streamed through the clouds and hit the key that was hanging in the tree.
The key to the locked room.
The key to the locked room, which we could not find. That was the first vivid recollection of it.
So it was definitely a spirit. It wasn't like you hallucinating. It was definitely Auntie Mary.
Yes.
But that wasn't the last time Mark would have a spooky encounter like this. He says his late grandfather and grandmother have both made contact. And perhaps one of the most bizarre moments came after his beloved mother passed away.
I'd come home and then my sister rang and said Mum had gone. I was at the computer and all of a sudden I became aware that of a presence behind me. And I turned around and it was my mother. She looked, I guess, the way she wanted to be. She didn't look like the way I'd known her. She was much younger and she smiled and said, "Goodbye, darling."
And that was it?
That was it.
So you think this is their way of saying goodbye?
I think this is what they do. And it's like a final farewell.
While some see Mark's ability as a gift, he views it quite differently, suggesting that many of us have the ability to tap into the afterlife.
Is this intuition something that any of us can experience?
We're told that there's no such thing as ghosts, and we're told that what we can't experience in the material world doesn't exist. We're told that when people die, they go to the next life or whatever, and so we don't accept it when it does. But I think it's an ability that we all have. We see it all the time in lots of incidental things. For example, you're thinking about something, then you look at the TV guide an hour later, and there it is. We seem to tap in to the great cosmic mind, or something. It's something going on, some lake, as it were, that we can dip into. And I think everybody has this experience. Well, I think everybody's open to this. Who is open to this experience has it, probably.
These experiences with the dead have given Mark a sense of calmness when contemplating his own death.
I hope I'm awake when I die.
Why is that?
Well, if that's the last experience, I'd like to have it. I don't want to die in my sleep.
And while there will be sceptics out there who doubt Mark's gift, one thing is certain. He will always have his wicked sense of humour.
Craig under the sheet.
I think it's Craig under the sheet. It's so interesting, though. I find that kind of fascinating. Because I do believe in a bit of a sixth sense.
Mm. But does he see things or is he psychic? That's what I was wondering.
I think psychic means you can look into the future, doesn't it? Being able to... You're a medium if you can talk to the dead.
I don't know.
But he says he actually sees them. He sees visions of them. Which, I definitely saw someone moving under that sheet just before, so I'm
Do you think you can see people after they're dead, Joe?
I work in the media industry. I see lots of dead people all the time.
But you'd also be more sceptical than others working in the media industry, would you not?
That's right. Well, usually when they come back to haunt you, it's because they're telling you you've been fired.